I don't feel even I want to work. I am forcing myself to work now because we have to make a living.
Taxi cab drivers throughout the city are calling for more security measures after at least two cabbies were robbed and carjacked on the job. Good evening tonight. We spoke to some drivers today who say the ruling surround or the rules surrounding their industry favor the passenger, but they're also at risk. WDSU reporter Sydney Chewin joins us live from the French Quarter with more on the investigation and what they want done to keep cabbies safe.
Norman, I'm standing in the 900 block of Rampart. This is where two cabbies picked up fares earlier this week. It ended with one of them being robbed and carjacked. And tonight, cabbies say they're just asking the city for more safety and protection.
So I felt any second I could die. The 40 seconds I spent with him in that street, I felt like 40 hours.
Early Tuesday morning, American cab driver Omar Kasim was the victim of an attempted armed robbery, but the suspect had a change of heart after Kasim told him he had no cash.
He said, I'm sorry, I should not do that, just to drive off and I keep going.
Kasim never reported his encounter to police, but the MO is strikingly similar to two other cases in the same 48-hour window. In both, the cabbies picked up fares in the French Quarter. They were told to head to St. Bernard and Broad, but somewhere along the way in the 7th Ward, both cabbies ended up getting robbed and carjacked. Police believe the same man is behind both crimes. Jason Coleman of Coleman Cabs says these incidents highlight the risk drivers face daily. The city adopted a passenger's Bill of Rights last fall, but drivers are asking for their own Bill of Rights, one of which Coleman believes can prevent them from being targeted.
Being able to refuse the passengers that have some offensive nature or tendencies, to be able to stop that from happening before the driver gets robbed or carjacked.
As it stands now, cabbies say they can be penalized if they refuse a customer, while the city is discussing other safety measures, such as in-car video cameras. Taxi drivers say action must be taken soon.
When it comes to our rights or our way of life, we don't see any type of effort with the current administration and urgency with the city council.
Omar Kasim says he would like to see a taxi driver's Bill of Rights adopted soon, as this is the second time he's been victimized in 2 months. The first time, he says, he was robbed in New Orleans East. Meanwhile, as for those recent carjackings and robberies, the car was later recovered. Police say it appears the car was not damaged and it was likely just used as a getaway. On your side, live from the French Quarter, Simney Chuan, WDSU News.
Thank you, Simney. New Orleans City Councilwoman Kristen Palmer says she hopes a committee of taxi cab drivers and owners put together by the Landry administration will help come up with new safety measures. She also says, quote, I fully support measures that provide a safer experience for both passengers and drivers, such as GPS tracking systems, security cameras in vehicles, and emergency call buttons, end quote. Cab driver safety has prompted changes in other cities across the country. According to the U.S. Department of Labor, taxi drivers in the U.S. are 80 times more likely to be robbed doing their job than any other occupation. The city of Honolulu installed GPS technology in cars so drivers could connect with emergency dispatchers instantly. And cities like New York have installed bulletproof dividers in and in-car video cameras.